Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We just had major surgery, had a personal data tag ripped out of our back, and not feeling too well, but hopefully now we can get into this elevator and finally advance onward. Hope it's worth it. Yes, I love you too. Yes, I know. Is a dead body in here with me or no?
A biological quarantine has been initiated.
Okay. This doesn't look like a body. I thought it was all this time.
Level 2. Kitchen knife and snowflake are off limits.
What am I gonna use to cut my meat?
Level 3. Hydroponics is off limits.
Well, you know, fun. Oh, jeez. Okay. I guess this is our final destination. Oh my god.
Perfect.
Where are you, John? What about the PDT? I can't track shit.
Hydroponics. Well, what's left of hydroponics? The shaft's covered in growth. I'm not going anywhere.
Listen, wait. Let me check the blueprints. Yes. Hydroponics has a service elevator.
Affirmative.
Keep me in the loop.
Isn't that where we are? A service elevator? The vines may attempt to redecorate the elevator before too long. Vines covering the elevator shaft. The vines have grown so abundantly that their thick protuberances have pushed through into the neighboring laboratory. This doorway's bright lighting indicates the entrance to another laboratory. Yeah, I realize I used two different pronunciations. The creeping growth on this level has upholstered the drab surfaces in an almost comforting fabric of green. I was gonna say, it looks rather nice. Another laboratory here. Although the fans were installed to keep the air cycling, they're now helping reduce the buildup of vegetation. Oh, I don't have different flavor text for each one. So we got another laboratory. So we've got three laboratories. Where's a dead body? Edwin Tiong, civilian. Security level 0. I can't advance. I guess I don't care about that corpse. Alright, let's go to the left.
This is ridiculous. How did it grow this world in a few months?
The cloning plants too? Vaporizer pad. This is an evaluation platform.
These plants can naturally develop this fast.
Cain developed the technology to accelerate plant growth. Oxygen is big business.
Okay, are you two done now? So the vaporizer pad, this is an evaluation platform for specimens and samples to be inserted into the glass chambers. Cracked glass. This vaporizer has been punctured by a hole, leaving a spiderweb of cracks in the glass. So we can look at... The air is filled with a distinctive jungle scent. Plants are producing odors that are sweet, creamy, and seductive in equal measure. Really? The surprisingly pleasant aroma of the undergrowth is kept in check by the hard-working fans. So these have different descriptions. Another monitor displaying the vessel's favorite show, static. A small work desk. Computer terminal. All kinds of neat things. Another computer terminal. The vaporizer lies broken beyond repair, wrapped in vines. Wrestled from their upright position, the vaporization chambers are now resting idly on the floor. The vines have covered many of the laboratory's surfaces. In some areas, the wall and floor can't be seen behind the tangled weave. This door appears to be locked. A network of green veins snake across every surface. James Herbert. That's an author, isn't it? James Herbert? Deckhand. Security level 0. Kita Yamada, civilian liaison. Security level 1. Hybrid engines? There's two of them. Liquid stains on wall. A green scum has dripped down from the ceiling, staining the wall. Metal plaque. A polished metal plaque is engraved with the slogan, "Gardening, just another day at the plant." We can take that, apparently. Do you have anything to say about this stuff? Just trying, because sometimes we will mark on things.
Another locked door.
We hate locked doors, don't we, John?
Kane Corporation is watching you. We care.
Okay, so you're stalking me, but you care. I've heard that before. Metal plaque. See if I can take this. Got it. Alright, so the only thing to do is mess with these two terminals. The vaporizer! Report! Huh. The vaporizer, the perfected Mark V model of the Kane Corporation Trans-State Modifier. Using advanced and unique molecular... Oh wow, that's a word. Molecularization technology, the vaporizer has the ability to shift a targeted substance between gas, liquid, and solid states, really, without any of the structural breakdown seen in objects shifted between states on a regular basis. That's pretty awesome. So we can turn water into, you know, ice or steam vapor or water. The Mark V is the latest model, but it hasn't yet been rolled into mass production because of the current difficulty fueling the vaporizer with resources on board the Groomlake. Recent experiments undertaken were more than satisfactory, and it passed the Kane safety and security tests with no adverse effects causing harm to the user observed. Yeah, those safety and security tests are pretty lacking, though, I have to say. At least from what I've been observing so far. So remember the methane gas leak right under, or just the fact that it was kept underneath the personal quarters. Wonderful. It has been graded level 4 because of the specific nature of its technology and the limited quantity of existing vaporizers. During an experiment recently carried out on the royal jelly produced by Hydroponics, Dr. Gray and other researchers... I thought that moved for a second. And other Dr. Gray and other observers commented on the remarkable speed in which the jelly was transformed into gas, thus placating their insect population. Alright. Activate vaporizer.
Vaporizer chamber compromised.
Yeah,
chamber
okay.
Is not yet right.
Maybe I'll put the plaque over it. Cracked glass. Well, yeah, I got separate... Cracked glass. Unattended for months, the vegetation is wickedly dense and as strong as twisted steel cables. Right, so I'm thinking I could put this over this.
I don't think that'll work.
Okay, or not. Tangle it up with my...
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
The glass, yeah. Alright, try this. Did you say anything about this monitor? No. Dr. Sebastian Gray, January 2nd. Finally! We have more room for the Lanessi-Harvey strain, which I've been working on so hard. It's days like this that humanity truly proves why it crawled out of the ocean before any other. My section has been expanded. I have more staff, true, but they are drones and have little other function. Drones. Now we can expand the research potential of Project Kitchen Knife and see what else the plants can yield. Okay. The oxygen production rate is quite unlike anything my initial projections could have predicted. Last year it became the worst kept secret on the Groomlake, and all of a sudden I had more interns than I could comfortably employ. Their only function is to stumble about the place and ask troublesome questions that I have little time to answer. If only our world was more like that of insects. I have plenty of workers and drones, but none of the unwavering loyalty. Bees work and work, the faith in their queen unquestioning and constant. That kind of loyalty is beyond price. These interns of mine have their uses, I suppose. We always need volunteers willing to get close to the queen. February 16th. Am I surrounded by incompetence? One of those imbecilic interns got too close to the queen and she showed him her affection. Quite amusing, though not to him. This means I must attend another accident debriefing with the board, though. Dr. Malin does love to test me. I see him up on the hearing bench and he grins at me in that supercilious look that he has perfected over the years. The queen. What? Is it insects? Or the queen of the Lessonessy Harvey strain, which... Yeah. Well, he's saying the staff are drones. Which confused me. Why are they gonna go to the queen? Bees work and work. I suppose I have him to thank for my current position. It was his recommendation to the board that made them hire me in the first place. Still, I believe he has come to enjoy these little power plays. He does so like to keep me under his heel. That, my dear doctor, is only a temporary situation. Once this project is complete, the chess games that we play so often will no longer be our only battleground. Regarding the project, some of the bug eggs failed to hatch properly. I suspect this is why the queen was more aggressive than usual. There are more than enough drones to continue the collection work. Their unique chemical properties are doing wonders for the plants, although I'm running short of interns prepared to work in close proximity to them since the last incident. The worker I appreciate the most is Akiza. I was astonished to discover that she is related to the legendary Dr. Tenshu of the Eugenics Wars. I did consider mentioning it to her, but I sense she is oddly ashamed to have him as her ancestor. If it wasn't for men like him, our profession would be a hollow shell of what it is now. Then again, if it wasn't for him, genetic research would have been put back by several generations, now would it? The ethical quandaries we face as men of science. June 16th. The insects are restless. They rumble in their apiaries and are more aggressive than usual. My personal deduction is that the presence of the marine thugs aboard the ship are the cause. Armed guards all over the place. I was stopped by one the other day and asked my reasons for going into hydroponics. Well, after explaining I was head of the damn project, I had the guard removed from his post, and then the ship. This is insanity. How am I expected to progress with these thugs around? Removed him from the ship? Only by ourselves? Did they space him? By space him... that's a term from Babylon 5. I don't know if it's used anywhere else. It's basically pushing you out the airlock into space. I mean, maybe there are transports that come and go from here? I don't know. Still remember the beginning. The cinematic showed it looked like a vessel tugging another vessel. And it looked like it was tugging the Groomlake. Unless it's... It looked like it had, like, chains or a rope or something like that. Metal cables, right? Going to the Groomlake to pull it? I don't know. September 23rd. I recall complaining about the inundation of interns. If only they were still here now. Both Ivan and Theodore disappeared from their rooms last night. Oh yeah, Ivan's gone, definitely. And I've had to speak to security about their whereabouts. They were Akiza's assistants, and now the production of the Queen's royal jelly has slowed exponentially. Why don't you just call it honey? That's been a huge blow, but a rather extraordinary anomaly has appeared in our growth pods. A hitherto undiscovered strain of fungus. Its origin is something of a mystery to me. So this is where the fungus came from? So this... Well, I'm just going to finish reading it. These fungal growths fungal growths fascinate. At first I thought it was a common garden variety mold, but after a substantial analysis performed by Akiza, it seems to harbor neuron activity. That is to say, it seems to exhibit rudimentary signs of intelligence. Really? Mold? Or fungus? Intelligent fungus. We certainly created some unusual species on this deck, but the idea of a quasi-intelligent fungus growing and evolving of its own volition is exciting and, frankly, frightening. I've asked Akiza and the remnants of her team to cultivate it, but exhibit caution in where it is spread. So this strain, I guess Lanessi Harvey strain? Are, yeah, bees. A strain of bees. I figured it was, you know, a strain I think of as a virus or possibly some kind of vegetation. So all that time this is, has to do with bees. October 24th. I was asked by one of Dr. Mallon's assistants if the fungal substance discovered growing in the bowels of the ship had anything to do with us. I lied, of course, but this is becoming alarming. Our experiments flourished at first, but we may have lost more staff recently. But our experiments have been very fruitful indeed. Coincidentally, the properties of the fungus is both extraordinary and terrifying. It has the remarkable ability to take control of a living subject's central nervous system and hypothalamus, as observed in the monkey we used for testing. The monkey shrieked and thrashed in rage for the first few days after it was exposed, and then it became quiet, observed, and uncannily intelligent. It's certainly aggressive, but then again, which viruses aren't? Well, that's so sad. December 1st. No! 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 We've officially lost control of the deck. Eden now truly belongs to the beasts. We've seen strange things. I watched as the fungus took control of the deck, as it spread through the staff, and much to my shame, I watched their deaths and examined their bodies. Nobody can cross the pods because the bugs are so aggressive that when Solomon went through in a rad suit, they ripped it from his body and stung him to death. It took mere moments.
Damn.
Still, I live in the hope that the insects will remember me, their creator, and perhaps see me as one of their own. Yeah. Somehow I doubt it. Emails! From Dr. Tenshu to Dr. Gray, re my family. Dr. Gray, I do not wish to seem unprofessional or impolite, but would ask that you not press me on the subject of my ancestry any further. I was nearly refused entry to medical school on the basis of my family's background, and the torment I suffered at the hands of my school peers regarding my great-great-uncle was unbearable. I am fully aware of his actions, and I've seen countless photographs and documents of the consequences of his work. I took this position to change our world for the better, not to be reminded of the skeletons in my family's closet. I have enjoyed our working relationship thus far, Dr. Gray, but I prefer my family history no longer be a topic of our conversations. Thank you for understanding, Akiza. From Dr. E. F. Way to Dr. Gray, re-meal. Who's... Eden? Or is he talking about this place as Eden? Ivan, Theodore, trying to figure out who that is. Maybe Erica? Oh, upstairs? Dr. E. F. Way. Dr. Gray, I enjoyed our meal yesterday. It was refreshing to hear a man so outspoken with this ship. I don't think Erica's a doctor. I appreciate your candor, and I do agree that perhaps it's time that the board was shaken up a little. Although this is merely an observation rather than an action plan, I think the top leadership needs some new blood. I'd second you if you decide to take on the challenge yourself. Your impeccable scientific pedigree more than qualifies you. By the way, did you know where they were keeping that new cargo? It seems rather like a waste of resources if they won't even tell us where it is. Regards, Dr. E. F. Way. Hmm. Thank you. So I need to find something to plug that up with. So maybe in one of these other rooms.
Probably not a good idea.
What else do I have? Well, I have the plaque. I suppose. No.
Probably not a good idea.
So I have the plaque, the gun, and the PDT. All right, let's go. Let's go this way to the right side laboratory. Oh, are those bees? Oh my. I think I should save. These things could sting me to death, right? And they probably will unless I distract them in some way. Chris Rogers, Helmsman, Groomlake Comms, Security Level 1. Oxygen collection tank. A gentle hiss indicates the oxygen collection tank continues to cycle. A soft mechanical inhalation sound is audible here while the tank collects oxygen produced by the room's abundant plant life. Overgrown seedlings. The sprouts in this planter have surged forth, straining to reach the hydroponic lights above. The vines are winning a slow methodical war to bend and rip this tree from its roots in the floor below. The fan's constant spins sends a heady blend of botanical scents through the room. This fan spins sluggishly as the vines through the gap in the blades have begun to wrap around it. Observation platform. The observation point towers above the growth pods, providing an incredible view of the lush Eden below. So this is the Eden, then. Collapsed bridge. The flora here grew steadily, wrapping its limbs around the catwalk. Slowly but inexorably, the flora pulled at the metallic structure until it collapsed. Jeez. Charles A. Young, security personnel, Kane Security, Security Level 1. Jim Taylor, senior security personnel, Kane Security, Security Level 2. I don't see any PDTs on these guys. A tank to collect the oxygen produced by the bountiful flora in hydroponics. Overgrown hanging vine. The hanging vine stretches across the room, its tendrils hanging down like a centipede's legs. You can't tell whether it's wrapped around an existing structure or whether it traveled the distance on its own accord. Oh, and if we can cross, we can go further. A growth agent has spurred this section of vine to flourish. It's now half as thick around as the hatch you entered through. This tree is a perfect example of a species that has been gene-tailored for generations to grow perfectly in hydroponic environment on vessels, lunar stations, and asteroid mining settlements. Oh, really? Specially made, huh? Genetically engineered.
Oxygen levels increasing.
Is that good? Yeah, I had a feeling. Oh God. Good God. Covered in them. And then he just exploded all over the monitor. No part of that just yet. Let's go this way. Oh, good God. What the hell?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah, really?
It's some sort of insect.
Oh, it is?
It's tied up. It doesn't look like it can get loose.
Tied up? How big is it?
I'd rather keep my distance. Yeah, that falls under category of big. Large swollen milk sac. A mottled abdomen. Oh wait, that's the actual insect, and this is a milk sac. A mottled abdomen, swollen egg sac, or plump milk gland. Possibly all three. Queen insect. It's difficult to grasp the size and form of this insect creature. Udder-like protuberances sprout from its bulbous abdomen while the pincers stab the air. Restraint harness. This series of oh look, it's like puffing stuff out. What's the deal with the smiling face? A series of struts hold the grotesque creature in place. I saw a red smiley face. Milking suction cups. Oh, they're milking her? What? Semi-organic suction cups are custom designed to harvest this creature's excretions. They're milking a giant insect. Oh my god. See that? Smiley face. The computer likes that? This computer? See, when it goes puff, you get the smiley face. Hardened amber. Amber trickles from the tree, but most of it has hardened into an incredibly tough compound. Is it spraying her, or is she spraying that stuff? A tall, strangely shaped tree grows out of a housing space in the floor. Milk from the creature is being fed into the tree by a pair of tubes. What? But why? Why, though? Why do that? The overgrown vines are no less dense in this room. Miss John. Yeah, why would you even do that? These tanks exist to collect what is being milked from the brute. Milk collection tank. Milk processor. This receptacle stores the processed milk. Well, if it's a milk processor, wouldn't it process and store the milk? I'm gonna mess around with this computer terminal. I don't know what the hell I'm doing, but... Hydroponics Queen Chamber. Activate suction cups. Activate suction cups. Reports. The Queen's life cycle. Week 93. Monday. Healthy. Docile. Responsive to stimuli. Milking is normal. Tuesday, no activity. Wednesday, healthy, heightened aggression. Recommended, milking with only experienced staff. Thursday, no activity. Friday, healthy, highly aggressive. Three personnel wounded in milking. Saturday, healthy, quiet, unusual brooding behavior. Milking normal. Sunday, healthy, aggressive. One fatality via venom pouches. Oh, God. Don't you want to stop these people from killing these people? Reports. Akiza Tenshu, personal logs. February 20th. Oh, praise God Almighty, I couldn't be happier. You sure? Dr. Gray took me to one side and told me that I was the only person who had the skill and ability to take control of the nursery. He promoted me on the spot and said that I was now personally responsible for the queen. The royal jelly that she produces has proved to be incredibly useful. I discovered through my own analysis that not only is the jelly an essential nutrient for the insect population, but that it has other amazing physical properties too. It accelerates molecular bonding in certain substances, acting as a thickener for many natural substances while also regenerating their natural properties. With some engineering, I thought we could turn this into a true medical breakthrough. I imagine doctors in the hospital wards on Earth using our bonding agent to heal wounds instantly. Perhaps finally the Tenshu name will be revered in medical history instead of reviled. Yeah, I don't think we can accomplish that. March 10th. The Queen is a temperamental little thing, a fiery lady to be sure. Ah, but Queenie, you forget. I grew up in a family with more than one fire-breathing dragon. If I can handle my mother, I can certainly handle you. Ha! Although, when she is milked, she's rather docile. I dare say she's rather attached to me. I'm sure I heard her purring at me. Purring? A bug purring. That's the only way I can describe it. I'm aware that she's a bug and all, but it sounded rather like approval. My parents kept hives of bees, so I've never been squeamish over insects, and I can tell the difference between aggression and favor. I'm still the only person who can get close without being bitten, and her bite can leave one hell of a mark, let me tell you. Hodgkin said he'll report his side effects upon his return from sick leave. In other news, Dr. Myrick, one of Dr. Gray's subordinates, has requested samples of this jelly for experiments with his tree resins. He thinks it might have a use as an industrial adhesive. This is a little way from my original intention, but I do suppose it's a start. August 12th. Drink. I try so hard to be positive, to be the person whose enthusiasm never once flags nor fails. But when you start hearing rumors that appall you to your very core, I tried to shrug it off, but recently it's become harder to deny it. I've been hearing sounds from the elevator shafts, the sounds of a wailing infant crying out in pain before suddenly being silenced. That is no rumor. Sometimes I lay awake at night and I swear I can hear the crying of children. I can't be dreaming. I saw Ingracia to confess my fears. He gave me a prescription to help me sleep, but something in his eyes said that he knew I was hearing something real, and worse, it was something he was hearing too. More rumors. Dr. Mallon is using children in his research. I have to ignore it. If it were true, Kane would remove him immediately. Surely. Even Dr. Gray appears to find it an uncomfortable subject for discussion, and this is a man who slept easily when Isaac got his left cheek torn off by the Queen. September 22nd. Is Dr. Gray short of staff again? Once again, I'm being forced to manage multiple projects, only this time it's an examination. He really, really hates managing multiple projects. It's an examination of an acutely destructive new spore that seems to have infected a few of the pods. First observation, it's a parasitic fungus that grows faster than a common weed, and like a common weed, I feel it should be destroyed. But I know that Dr. Gray won't do it. He, like so many of the other senior officers, sees any new species as something to be exploited or weaponized. October 31st. In the darkness, something stirs. I can't say what. I'm too afraid to find out what it is. When Ivan and Theo disappeared a month back, we assumed they'd somehow deserted. That was the official stance taken by Dr. Mallon and the board, anyway. Last night's events prove that there is something on board with us, though God knows where it's from. The Queen was more rambunctious than I've seen her before, and milking her was certainly more challenging than I'm used to. Edmund was assisting. We've been short on staff, and some of our volunteers are simply refusing to show for work. The Queen's environment has been disturbed a great deal, and so her violent tendencies are more pronounced. Edmund was on his way out into one of the air ducts. Edmund was on his way out of hydroponics when it happened. Something pulled him into one of the air ducts. Oh, is Edmund the one we saw in the air duct? I didn't see much. I saw him walking towards the decontamination chamber, and the next moment his legs were kicking the air as whatever it was dragged him up and into the ceiling while he squealed like a pig. But he got away because the guy we found in the shaft shot himself. I'm resigning tomorrow. I did not sign up for mad science. Mad science! Ooh! I came to Kane to serve humanity and clear my family's name and not watch my crewmates be slaughtered by a species that Dr. Mallon refuses to confirm or deny. December 3rd. If only I'd resigned when I said I would, and if only they hadn't ignored my demands to have the internal fungus removed, or destroyed, rather. It's growing over me now, over my skin. It's burrowing into my flesh. Oh, damn. This is the final entry. The infernal fungus, not internal. The insects attacked again today, and it seems to only worsen. Dr. Gray was destroyed by a swarm of them, and now he is only fertilizer for that ever-ravenous mold he was so curious about. The uninfected are making an attempt to escape. This doesn't include me. The emergency flares keep the bugs away. I told them to give me the flare to hold back the bugs so they could get away. I hope they escape soon. The fungus is making my head feel funny. I'm sure I can feel it growing through my ear canal. Ooh. Alright, so we want a flare, if we can find one. That will work. From Dr. Gray to Dr. Tenshu. Okay, from Dr. Gray to him, then. Foolish pranks. Azika. I thought it was Akiza. Azika, with the greatest respect, could you please stop the ridiculous pranks your group insists on carrying out in the fertilization chambers? I will admit that they're hardly dangerous, but they are undignified. I certainly wouldn't like to be present when a cane inspector stumbles upon young Theodore, racing in front of the queen, hands above his head while shouting, I'm covered in bees! Not the bees! It is unprofessional. Please instruct them to cease their foolishness at once. Kind regards, Dr. Gray. Hopefully it wasn't for real, though. From Dr. E.F. Way to Dr. Tenshu, re a matter of spirit. Akiza. Akiza. Wait. Akiza. Akiza. So it says Akiza here. Azika here. Could be actual typo as far as the game, or could be that's the way the person wrote Azika's name. Okay, a matter of spirit. Akiza, don't worry. I don't think that you're losing your mind. Ghosts are a possibility, but I suspect that what you're hearing is perhaps the sounds of devices playing in other parts of the ship. I do believe at the moment that the corporeal world and spirit world are very much divided. So try to calm yourself. If you'd like, I can talk to someone in cargo storage about those sounds, but I wouldn't worry about it. This island is full of noises, and pay them no mind, for once I'm quoting Shakespeare and not the Bible. Get some sleep and maybe do fewer night shifts. Eleanor. Okay, Eleanor is the name. Eleanor Gray. No, Eleanor Way. Gray is the doctor.